Ladies and gentlemen, this session comes at a critical time for the work of this organization and for children around the world. Despite enormous global progress over the past few decades, the lives and futures of children in every society remain marked by discrimination, poverty, inequity, and lack of access of basic services, which, together with climate change, is propelling the greatest displacement of children since World War II. UNICEF's strategic plan was crafted with a keen recognition of the organization's dual mandate to protect children's rights in both development and humanitarian contexts. Although ambitious, I am convinced that this is an achievable goal. As an ambassador in Afghanistan, I saw firsthand how UNICEF's education programming in a challenging humanitarian setting contributed to improved literacy rates and access to education for children, particularly girls. And as ambassador in Sri Lanka, I witnessed how UNICEF's tireless work on child and maternal health gave millions of families hope of a better future as their children grow and transform. Let us be mindful that the ultimate responsibility of the board is to enable the conditions so that UNICEF can deliver on its overall mandate to help the world children through the effective and strategic management of its governance agenda. Let us therefore follow UNICEF's laudable tradition of keeping the rights and well-being of children at the center of all discussions and to focus on the achievement of results by UNICEF on their behalf rather than on any political consideration.
I would like to begin with a heartfelt thank you to the members of UNICEF's Executive Board and also to the Secretary General for giving me the extraordinary opportunity to lead one of the best, most consequential organizations in the world. There is no more important cause than children. As they hold our futures in their hands, we hold their future in our hands. So I thank you for lending your commitment and ideas to this mission. My overarching priority for these meetings will be to hear from you and to discuss with you your ideas and vision for the future. So I'd like to allow as much time as possible for free and open exchange of ideas. We cannot achieve a sustainable tomorrow if we fail to serve the children of conflict, the most disadvantaged and discriminated, and poverty. The children remind us why equity is at the heart of the Sustainable Development Goals and that we should leave no child behind. And it is also at the heart of our strategic plan, which you approved in the last session of the board. The strategic plan's success depends on the ambitiousness of our work. We have our goals, and we have been working over the past 20 years. It has been a time of unprecedented progress. More children are living to their fifth birthday. More are going to school. Fewer are stunted by malnutrition than ever before. But as we look to realize the ambition of the strategic plan and the SDGs, and as the world commits to finishing and sustaining the unfinished business of the first decade of a child's life, we are also compelled to do more to address the second decade of a child's life. Today, we have 1.2 billion adolescents, the largest cohort ever, present, and thus it is an enormous opportunity to make targeted and timely investments that can pay enormous dividends for young people themselves and for the world as a whole. The significant opportunity is matched by an enormous challenge. Based on current trends, only 1 in 10 young people will gain the secondary level skills that they need by 2030. That's an extraordinary number. To address this challenge, UNICEF is pursuing an ambitious agenda focused on every young person being in school, learning, training, or age-appropriate employment by 2030, with a particular emphasis on the most vulnerable, girls, children, and young people who are on the move, and those living through humanitarian emergencies. We want to co-create, shape this agenda with a full range of partners and governments, global and local businesses, NGOs, and UN agencies. As we did during the child survival revolution of the 1990s, we can, together, achieve more impact and more results by identifying and applying accelerators like knowledge, data, digital solutions, and innovations. I look forward to hearing your ideas on how we can better support young people and children in their critical second decade. And a final word about UNICEF's greatest assets, our people. In the short time I have been here, I've been enormously proud and impressed by our UNICEF staff. I am committed to supporting them, and they in turn will support the children and the young people around the world.